Peter, today is World Mental Health Day, which I think is really important for the investment community because trading psychology is everything. So as you can see, we are having a pretty down day. What are some tips you can give our viewers on trading psychology? How do you get mental clarity on a day like this or any day?
You know what? I don't think that you need, if you're going to be sort of spiritually centered or you know, it's an up down, an up day that's up 400 or a down day that's up four, or down 400. You know, I don't think we should look at them differently as far as your mental health and your spiritual peacefulness in a matter of ways. You know, for me, every day is a different day. Every day has to start fresh, you know. You never go to bed angry. You know, gratitude is a huge, big thing, you know, in my world. And so, you know, look, we're talking about money. Money can be a big trigger for people, you know, but at the end of the day, the way the market has been lately, you know, I think you one day does not a market make, right? We're down here. It's a great day to address it. Market's down 400 points. I mean, there are people who thought the market was not going to come in at all or sell off at all are probably, you know, pulling their hair out right now. Then there's the other side of the trade. There are people who said, you know, enough is enough, and it, you know, no pain, no gain, risk, reward. It's a lot of things like that. But I usually just take it a day at a time. We wake up in the morning, be grateful, and hope that it's going to be a great day. And positive attitude is a huge thing. You know, there are going to be losing days. There are going to be winning days. I think positive attitude is a big deal.
Let us address the day.
So, look, we haven't seen a down day, you know, in a while. This is a really nice down day for me. You know, I think what's happening is that for the longest time, we have not engaged the potential negative narrative that's in the market. Right, we've had down days. You and I have talked about it. We've had down days about the trade wars and about the tariffs and whatnot. But what seems like it's happening right here is that normal triggers to sell a market are spikes in the yield 10-year and raising interest rates. Right? Okay, those are normal triggers, economic data that would normally trigger a sell-off. And so, you know, I think this is sort of a healthy shakeout. And, you know, we've seen this before. It's sort of reminiscent for me. When the market broke 17,000 way back, I remember sitting with Arthur Cashin, and I had my 18, we got up to 17,993, and we were about to break out the 18,000 hats. And the market sold off, you know, it was sort of, I think we may have taken the hats out because we were 6 points off the 18,000 level. The market proceeded to sell off 983 points and actually got down to 17,000 before it made its way up. Once we shake out that, you know, that negative narrative, I think we'll be fine.
Sure. I think that, you know, some people feel like it was already baked in, and maybe that interest rates, like we thought it was already baked in. Sure, we knew it was going to happen. But you know what? Like you said, I guess we didn't, and we're just getting it over with. It was going to happen.
And it was going to happen, correct.
It was going to happen. All right, well, thank you. And you know what, Peter? Thank you for your health tips on mental clarity today, guys.
Mental clarity.
Yes,
it's key. Wake up every morning and decide today's going to be a good day. And if it's not, you can restart your day anytime during the day.
That is great. You know what? We're going to sign off on that. Thank you so much, Peter. I'm glad I got you today. That's great.
Glad you got me, too. See you later.
I got you, babe. Bye, Peter. Thank you.
Bye.